He played like the birds fly, swift and light. Suddenly, the position could get frozen, and then one would get a glimpse of the universe of variations hidden below the sky that Hu had spawned in the earlier stages. On an early Sunday morning of 2014, a legend passed away, just 100 years after the gift of his birth. Although in the West we all know the name Go Seigen, coming from the Japanese Go Seigen, his original name was in fact Wu Qing Yuan, meaning clear and pure source of water in Chinese. This double name, still in use in each respective country, seems like a reminiscence of the conflictual past between both nations. A tragic time Go was living in, as he was born on the 12th of June 1914, just at the dawn of World War I, just 20 years after the First Sino-Japanese War. But these tragic times will reveal to be very prosperous for the game of Go, as the sayings of a father will change the future of the game. I will pass my calligraphic skills to my oldest son, my writing skills to my second oldest son, my Go skills to my youngest son. And his youngest son was in fact Wu Qingyuan. For example, Honinbo Dosaku discovered the game at 7 years old and Honinbo Shusaku discovered the game at 6 years old. Nonetheless, he would quickly set off to be a Go prodigy. And after a short time playing with his father and his brother, he would quickly be the strongest of the family. After that, his father had to give him game records. And as soon as the boy touched the records, he became very addicted to them. All the ancient Chinese players, like Wang Longshu, made up the dream of Wu Qingyuan. But his father, after a trip to Japan, brought back game records of Honinbo Dosaku, and these were treasures to his eyes, studying with Honinbo Dosaku all day and all night. One day, the family decided to test the young boy's skills, and so they decided to arrange a meetup with a strong player from Beijing, Lin. And Lin was destroyed in the middle game fight. And the name Wu Qingyuan became very famous among the Fuzhou people. And by the time he was 12, he was already considered to be of professional strength, as shown by his games against Iwamoto Kaoru's six-down professional visiting China in 1926. His reputation quickly spread to Japan, as he was able to beat very strong Japanese players, and even Inoue Tsuyoshi, who will later be the Prime Minister of Japan in 1931, for which Go Seigen had to say in an interview,
"The invitation to come to Japan from two of the top people in Japan. I am still very proud of the fact that these important figures in Japan came to ask a Chinese boy, would you believe, whether he wanted to come to Japan one day. Many people do not know that and think that I came to Japan off my own bat. I came here at the same time as a guest. And several highly placed people in the Go world, including Honinbo Shusai Meijin, came specially to Tokyo to welcome me."
Wu Qingyuan, or Go Seigen, was well known in both countries, now playing for the Nihon Kin at 16 years old. Well known in tragic times, as 1931 marked the arrival of Japanese troops invading provinces of China, led by Japanese war chief, eager for recognition and to see the expansion of their country. The Japanese invasion of Manchuria in September of this year marked the start of the Second Sino-Japanese War, continuing all through the Second World War.
Go is a game full of conflicts, and if a man could handle all these conflicts in a simple manner and win, I would say he's a genius. This genius was Go Seigen.
Wu Qingyuan becomes Go Seigen as he enters Japan. Analyzing his game records when Go was only 11 years old, Segoe Kensaku, a professional player known today to be Shohun Yun's teacher, thought he was Shusaku when incarnated. And so he made him his pupil. Thanks to his peculiar, very modern vision of the game and Mr. Segoe's tutoring, Go Seigen began to rise on the top of the professional Go world. And in 1930, he was given the right to play in the LTI, which is the grading tournament. At the time, it was one of the most important events. At only 18 years old, he would have gained a name for himself, as everywhere he played, his results were brilliant. Everyone who had doubts of this young Chinese teenager could do nothing but accept the fact that he was a gift to the Go world. And 2 years later, in 1932, He was already 5-dan professional, which is a very big feat, as gaining one grade in this time was very hard. Being 5-dan meant that Gosegen was part of the elite now. And being part of the elite meant that he could play against the top professional player of the time, the Meijin and Honinbo Shuzai. Gosegen lost to the Meijin by only 2 points. After playing for almost 5 months, and after the game was adjourned almost 10 times, creating a furor in the newspapers. There even was some drama, created by a rumor from an off-the-record conversation with Go's teacher Segue Kensaku. A rumor that says that one of the brilliant moves found in the games against the Meijin was in fact a move created by Maeda Nobuki, one of his pupils. But when this arrived in the newspapers, the whole Honinbo school was very furious, and Segue Kensaku, Go's teacher, began to receive a lot of threatening letters.
A villain. He was a villain. He is now praised to the skies by the Kin and depicted as one of the heroes of the century. Yet, mark you well, he sold his title to the newspapers for mere luck and bought with his fair-sized piece of land in Tokyo without giving 1 cent to the Kin or the Go world.
It was, and still is today, considered to be one of the greatest games of the century. And one of the first games where Gosegen really established his new vision of the game, his new modern way of creating openings, the Shin Fuseki.
The period of Shin Fuseki was not only the period of the early days of two personable young men, Kitani Minoru and Gosegen. It was without doubt also the period in which the foundations of modern Go were laid. Shin Fuseki was the fresh wind, the fan, the flames of enthusiastic, youthful creativity and adventure. Shin Fuseki ensured, through its glittering appearance and staggering sparkling content, that the whole Go world underwent a rejuvenation. It is, without a doubt, true that there were among the generation of Kitani and Go other brilliant players, but among them were none who had had such a marked influence on the Go world as the newcomers, Kitani and Go. During the period of Shin Fuseki, they revived the Go world. The new opening theory of Kitani and Go became the symbol of the blooming of Go in the 20th century.
And during these games, Gosegen played fast, very fast. His positional judgment and reading accuracy were no match, as he used the thickness created by his new vision of the opening. A revolutionary experimentation, creating the foundation of the Go we now have today. Don't be scared to fight. Get to the big points first, never lose a Go you initiate, and don't hesitate to exchange huge chunks of territory and turn the table if needed. As the universe creating the head of Gosegen while he's playing seems to never be fixed. Everything can change on the board, he will always adapt. That is how I would sum up Gosegen's style. While growing each and every day to be the legend we know of today, Go was still living in a world of trouble. The newspapers had the greatest idea to advertise the game against Honinbo Shuzai as the confrontation between China and Japan, thus putting Gosegen in a situation where he became the unfortunate victim of the rising nationalism in Japan. The young prodigy from China was constantly harassed during the matches he played, as even the window of the house he lived in was smashed with rocks. He is scared for his family and his own life. In 1936, at 22 years old, a previously diagnosed tuberculosis took over his body. He suffered a relapse of the disease. He is sick of politics, sick of the world he lives in, as he goes near Mount Fuji to rest and breathe for a while.
As time flew by, I felt the world was going through turbulent changes. Only the world of Go was as tranquil as Taikoko Lake. I could not abandon Go, my calling. I wanted to live with it in this world.
His love for the game was stronger than anything else. And now trouble seems far away as he regained the courage to play as a professional player. Now 25 years of age and 7-dan professional, Gosegen started a series of jubangos, meaning 10 games played in a row to agree on a decisive winner. This was well before Komi. And the first Jubango he played was against his old-time friend Kitani Minoru, 7-dan also at the time. and both players demonstrated their ingenuity and new discoveries of the Fuseki in a very beautiful manner. But Kosegen was just a tad stronger, as he managed to win the Jubongo. In fact, after 6 games, he had lost only 1 against Kitani Minoru, thus forcing him to put 1 stone handicap. This was pretty crazy at the time, as these were the top players.
He was 8 dan in 1941, defeating 4-1 Karigane Junichi 8 dan, then Hashimoto Utaro 8 dan, Fujisawa Kuranosuke 9 dan, Sakata Eyo 8 dan, and Takagawa Kaku 8 dan.
Now 9 dan since 1950, he had lost only 1 of 12 Jubangos against Fujisawa Kuranosuke. But you have to note the fact that due to the difference in strengths between the two players, Fujisawa had to play black in all the games. Kosegen is at the top of the world, and in 1942, he married his wife, a college student named Kazuko Nagara. They both quickly became involved in a religious movement we can now call a sect, or in Japanese term, a Shinchukyo. A word to describe the new religious movement established in the 1900s in Japan. And its mission was to save Japan and its people from misery and teach the eternal unchanging truth. He appeared to be more interested in religion and spirituality than the game of Go. Until 1948, where he left the sect with his wife. Apart from that, his career is an example of steadiness. Well, until the summer of 1961. In a rush and not really wanting to lose time using the pedestrian crossing, a motorcycle came out of nowhere and hit the poor man. He was hospitalized. And at first, doctors thought he would be well on his feet in no time. But after this incident, Go began to suffer bouts of dizziness. Well, he still played, but he could never withstand longer games, as he would suffer terrible nausea and other health issues. He had to retire at an early age, then officially in 1983. He was awarded the Grand Cordon of the Order of the Rising Sun for his lifetime contributions to Go by Japanese government the same year. And despite everything, he would continue to live for the game, remaining very active in the Go community. He still had Rin Kayo and Hui Naiwei as disciples, and wrote books like A Way of Play for the 21st Century or Modern Joseki Application Dictionary. Kosegen was buried, according to his wishes, in his hometown of Fuzhou in China, leaving behind him a new generation of Go players, professionals or amateurs, all walking in his footsteps, learning from the rich past he gifted us.
He's tired.
Thank you for watching, and thank you, Kosegen. Rest in peace.